So our police commissioner just made a statement saying people shouldn't give money to the homeless. And your character is someone who has a drug habit and mm-hmm. does use money sometimes towards that habit. So where do you stand, having investigated this and researched it for the film, on the giving versus not giving?
Well, I think that there's certainly ways for people to get involved. There's a wonderful organization called Coalition for the Homeless here in New York City. And for people who want to get involved, I think that's a wonderful place to start. You can look on their website, and there are ways to help financially or with your time. That's where I go when I want to be involved.
Well, also, your character here, and you've portrayed this before, you know, no matter how far women seem to come, when, you know, the bleep hits the fan, it always is like you have to sell your body to some degree. So how is it to reconcile that women always sometimes find themselves pushed back to, like, the most primal square one?
So your question is, how do I...
Well, how is it, like, as a woman today and as an actress to be like, okay, women are still finding themselves in this spot, you know, like, that it doesn't change?
Yeah. It's not... I mean, I think we... Anyone would say it's a terrible... You know, this is horrible that she's in
mm-hmm.
this situation. You know, mm-hmm. I mean, it's devastating for her. It's, you know, these are devastating... stories, you know. She's a woman who is trying to, you know, she's trying to escape something. You know, she experiences something traumatic and awful, mm-hmm. and then she starts going down this road, which actually the solution that she's seeking creates more of a so huge of a problem that becomes a thing that she doesn't know how to escape. You know, mm-hmm. there's such mess that comes together, that comes along with that attempted solution, you know. So I think it's heartbreaking. I think it's heartbreaking, and I have immense compassion for her and for, you know, women who find themselves in that situation.
Well, so you're making this movie with your husband. It's a very complex, emotional, dark place to go. How is it when you stop shooting for the day? What is it like to go home? You know, you have kids together. You know, does it bleed over? How do you compartmentalize?
It's lovely to go home.
Oh.
I love going home at the end of the day. I love going home to my extraordinary kids who are just such amazing people. And I'm so grateful to spend time with them every day. You know, I go home, I think about work anyway, you know, I'm like, mm-hmm. It's hard for me. I mean, I don't, you know, I'm not trying to, like, stay in a mood or push anything, but, you know, I'm deliberating, I'm thinking about, in the back of my mind, I'm thinking about, okay, this is what we shot, this is how it went, this is how it's different from what I had anticipated. How do I process that? Where do I go with what's left to come, given this, you know, because I'm always trying to think about how things are going to fit together and how one piece impacts another piece. And I do that anyway, so it was kind of nice doing it on the same, you know, I'll talk to Paul anyway about it, like, hey, I had this idea and this happened at work and I'm thinking about this, and at least on this one, it was on the same project, so it was kind of, it worked out. It's handy.
It's very interesting that you say that your perception of the character and the role can change while you're shooting. Did anything surprise you when you were making the movie?
Always. It always happens. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, because I like to do a lot of work, a lot of research, and spend a lot of time sort of thinking about the character and then making decisions about who she is, where she's come from, what she wants, what things mean in a concrete way, and what she does and how she spends her time and all that kind of stuff and where she's come from. But then in the moment, I don't want to be in my own world. I want to be in a scene. I want to be able to, you know, hear what's happening, and things sometimes just go differently than, you know, you can only sort of calculate so much. And at a certain point, I feel like I try and surrender to what's happening on the day. And sometimes it comes out really differently than something that you think might work, try, and it just isn't working, and you go in a different direction, and, you know, just kind of go with that.
That's fascinating. That's really interesting, because you have such a great reputation as a really organic actress. So it's cool to see how it takes shape.
Yeah, it really does. And every take sometimes, you know, is different. You know.
Well, you know, Richard Gere also recently played a homeless person.
I want to see that film.
He had a really interesting experience where people felt they didn't recognize Richard Gere. They just saw a homeless man. Did you have a similar experience shooting this film?
Yeah, like the scenes, I think so, yeah. I mean, I remember we were shooting in Astor Place. There's a sequence in the movie where I'm, you know, I come and I'm trying to make money. Mm-hmm. Sitting in Astor Place, I have my sign, and I have a sign that says, I used to be someone. Mm-hmm. And the crew was, at that point, we just came in very early in the morning, and I went into Astor Place, and they were way across the street with a long lens shooting, so I was just kind of by myself there by the sculpture. And yeah, people were coming up to me, and I had one woman come up to me and say, you still are someone. And she gave me money, and I felt bad, actually.
Well, you're bringing awareness. Confusing. You're bringing awareness, so I think that's
That's
really nice. And the last thing I want to ask you is, you were in the first Hulk movie, and now comic book movies are really becoming huge, right? Mm-hmm. So, like, what kind of role would interest you in maybe going back to Blockbusters?
It's a different kind of enterprise, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, they're fun. It's fun to see those movies for different kinds of reasons than it is to see this kind of a movie, you know? I don't know, like, I like action movies. I like action movies, but I'm not as interested in being like the girl who gets saved. I want to be kind of like, I'm more interested in being like the badass, you know?
Well, those roles are changing.
Yeah.
So, you know,
the one who's got something to her, you know?
Mm-hmm.
That'd be fun.
Definitely. Thank you so much for your time.
Okay.
Thank you. It was nice talking
to you.